Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching the Today I Found Out YouTube channel, and in the video today, we're looking at what exactly causes blisters. We've all seen them, and unfortunately, most of us have had one. Those painful pockets of goo that form because some over-exercised, over-caffeinated, happy-to-be-living-life outdoorsman decides to include you in their daily torture fest. That is a hike up Mount Agony. So, what exactly is going on here that causes the formation of a blister? So, let's start off with the anatomy involved. For the most part, there are three layers of tissue that surround our bones and organs. The first layer is called the epidermis. This is the outermost layer of skin. The second, or middle layer, is called the dermis. And the third is called the subcutis, also known as the subcutaneous. Together, these three layers make up the largest organ in the body, our skin. The epidermis itself has 4 to 5 layers. Most areas of skin have 4, but in regions such as your fingertips, palms of your hands, and the soles of your feet, where the skin is exposed to greater friction forces, there are 5. Starting from the deepest layer and working out, there is the stratum basale, the stratum spinosum, the stratum granulosum, the stratum lucidum, and the stratum corneum. The stratum lucidum is that extra friction-induced layer that helps make your skin thick in those areas that require it. Friction blisters are just that, the result of friction. What's going on under the surface is the repeated rubbing over one area of your skin will create forces that cause mechanical fatigue of the epidermis. This fatigue causes a split in the epidermis that usually resides at the layer of the stratum spinosum. When these cells separate, hydrostatic pressure allows a plasma-like blister fluid to form in this space. This fluid is similar to blood plasma in that it has the same electrolyte concentration, but with a much lower protein level. Should you continue the sadistic massage of your skin, the outer three layers of your pus pocket will break open, your salty fluid will leak out, and this portion of your epidermis will slough off. Resulting exposure to the last layer of the epidermis and the dermis itself, where your nerves are, is the red area that hurts like hell should you want to poke it with a stick. The recovery of your exposed blister will begin after approximately 6 hours, as the remaining cells under your blister begin the process of healing. 24 hours into your rehabilitation, the cells are dividing like a mid-1990s Microsoft stock. One day later, around 48 hours into the restoration of your epidermis, a new granular layer, stratum granulosum, can be seen. After approximately 5 days, this surge of cellular growth begins to slow down, and a shiny new stratum corneum layer begins to show itself, and your new skin is ready. Most blisters caused by friction do not require a doctor's care. If the blister doesn't pop, new skin will form under the affected area, and the fluid is simply absorbed. Try not to puncture a blister unless it is large, painful, or likely to be further irritated. The fluid-filled blister keeps the underlying skin clean, which prevents infection and promotes healing. Should you need to burst your bubble, it might behoove you to follow a few simple techniques. Use a sterilized needle or razor blade. To sterilize it, put the point or edge in a flame until it is red hot, or rinse it in alcohol. Wash the area thoroughly, then make a small hole and gently squeeze out the clear fluid. If the fluid is white or yellow, the blister may be infected and needs medical attention. Do not remove the skin over a broken blister. The new skin underneath will benefit from this protective layer. Look for signs of infection to develop. These include pus drainage, red or warm skin surrounding the blister, or red streaks leading away from the blister. So I really hope you found that video interesting and hopefully useful. If you did, please do give us a like below, and don't forget to subscribe for new videos every day. Also, over there on the right are a couple of other videos you might enjoy if you enjoyed this one, and thank you for watching.